Hello, doers. You ever waited so long for a package you forgot you ordered it? Like when I waited 2 years for my Cat Atlantis keycaps? And I was so over them by that time, so I have these ones now. Now you see, at Stealthy Wood, we take control and we avoid production delays by scheduling orders based on production and delivery times. By accurately estimating delivery times, we ensure that the parts arrive just as we need them, and manufacturing orders are completed just in time for shipping. Now this not only eliminates the need to keep parts and finished products in stock, but it keeps us efficient, because to put it simply, a lead time is the amount of calendar days that it takes for a process to be completed from start to finish. Now there are lots of different types of lead times, including customer lead times, which it's the number of days between when the product is ordered and when it's left the warehouse, basically. Now remember, Odooers, this is actually important here. Now whenever we're talking about customer lead time, we're referring to the delivery lead time. And next, we have manufacturing lead time, or the number of days it actually takes us to build a product. Now, in this video, I'm going to show you a cool new feature inside of Odoo called Days to Prepare Manufacturing Order. Now, with it, we'll know when we need to order necessary parts. They are mini deadlines and reminders that help us finish manufacturing on time. Now, let's start clickety-clacking away at the essence of logistics. All right, so let's begin on the manufacturing app, and we're going to take a quick look at the sturdy table that I'm selling. Now, we can find it by going up here to products, and selecting sturdy table. Perfect, we're here at the product form. Now, to start, and this is important, we define the manufacturing lead time on the product form. So we'll also click on the inventory tab, and you'll find the manufacturing lead time field located in the logistics section over here. In our case, we're going to say that it takes us 5 days to build a sturdy table. Now, the customer lead time below here is the time between when a customer places an order and when we ship our sturdy table out. We're using the 00 reordering rule to replenish our stock and plan when to begin manufacturing. So we can estimate that the whole process takes us 2 weeks, 14 days. Now, again, this is also known as the delivery lead time. And if you don't believe me, hover these little question marks. They always give you small little information and bits of stuff. All right, next, let's check on the 00 reordering rule configs by clicking on the reordering rule smart button up here. Beautiful. All right, now 00 is a nickname for a reordering rule where the minimum and the max quantity are both set to 0 in this case. Now, this means that we don't want to keep any finished table or its components in stock, but we'll start manufacturing one when a customer places an order. So what happens if a customer cancels that order? Well, Odoo stores that table and seeks to deplete it when someone else orders it, bringing the max quantity again to 0. Now, the same goes for the opposite. When a customer orders a sturdy table, the forecasted quantity over here turns to -1, which is a signal for Odoo to reorder and bring the number back to 0. With how 00 works in mind, here's a Jose quick tip. Click on this awesome little eye, and that'll take you to a lead time breakdown to get a better idea of when we can expect the finished product, which is a forecasted date. But like with all things such as forecasts on the replenishment info page, calculate estimated dates based on lead time values from the product form and global security lead times. And then they output those estimated date values in calendar days, meaning they don't take work center working time into account. Now, let's tackle days to supply components. So let's take a look at the bill of materials, or BOM for my acronym lovers, for the sturdy table. So we're gonna go back over here and select our bill of materials smart button, and we're gonna go right in there. Beautiful. Now we'll notice that the parts needed to build the table are the table legs and the large wood planks. But next, let's click on this overview. And would you look at that? Currently, the availability column for both the sturdy table and the table legs is showing not available because we haven't properly set up the purchase lead time for the table leg component, actually. So let's take a look at the table legs directly from the table. Now, if we do that, that'll actually open up the product form. And then we're going to switch on over here to purchase. And there's our problem. We don't have a default vendor. In our case, we're going to use the one that we've been working with a lot. And they sell it to us for $5, and our delivery lead time is 4 days. All right, beautiful. Everything is set up. Manual cloud save up here. Okay, so if we go back to the BOM overview, in our case, using the breadcrumbs, which today are sourdough, look at that. It went from not available to giving us estimated dates. And that's because now that the lead time for the table legs is set up, the report has been updated with an availability for both of them. And it tells us the exact estimated date that we anticipate finishing manufacturing the table. Beautiful. So based on the lead time set previously that we have over here, the earliest date we'll have the finished product is in 9 days. Now that's because even if we ordered the components today, the large wood plank comes in 2 days and the table legs come in 4 days. And I'd also like to make a quick note that the component with the longest lead time is used to calculate the days to prepare manufacturing order. And I'm going to show you what that means. So in our case, we're actually going to go back to the sturdy, you know, the sturdy table product page using the breadcrumbs. And it's the leftmost one at this point. All right, now that we're here in the logistics area, you'll notice we could either manually select days to prepare manufacturing order or compute. And boom, would you look at that? Beautiful. It pulls 4 days, which was the longest lead time to manufacture or purchase the components from the BOM. Now, this is helpful when you have tons of components and lead times. And now I'm going to show you a quick summary of all of that. All right, so in summary, the 14-day customer lead time is a default timeline for producing a sturdy table. 5 days from when we've placed a sales order, we get an alert on the replenishment report to create a manufacturing order. Now, this triggers 00 to get our parts from the vendor, which arrives on the 9th day, June 1st. Now, this date is also the scheduled date on the MO, which is the last day to begin manufacturing the sturdy table to ship it on time on June 6th, Odooers. But let's see how this works when we create a sales order for a different product, our driftwood table, which has all of the lead times set up exactly like the sturdy table we were working on earlier. All right, so here we are, and we're going to make a new quotation. And in this case, our customer Tom Hanks wants to order one driftwood table because he cast away his last one. Perfect. Driftwood table. And we are all set. All right. Now, Tom Hanks, while we're determining the delivery date, tells us, hey, I really don't want to wait even one extra day. I'm anticipating my first meal with Wilson on this table. Let's not disappoint him. In our 14-day timeline for our regular customers, we don't even order components until the 5th day. Skipping all of the waiting, we'll use the BOM overview to give him an estimate of the soonest available table. So we're going to go directly using our internal link just for him because we're trying to be very kind. Bill of materials in there and overview. All right. Now, boom, the date's right there. The finished table will be ready in 7 days, 2 days earlier than the forecasted date I showed you before. And that's because I have all of the table legs in stock. So I only need to wait 2 days to prepare the other components as well. Combined, we get 5 days to manufacture the table over here using the lead times. And then we can finish it in 7 days. Now this report can give accurate time estimates for different quantities as well. Now if Tom wanted, let's say another table and we click up here and we do two, you'll see something else happens now. The forecasted date is updated now to show us a longer time, because we'd have to wait the full 4 days for vintage goods to ship the table legs. So we promised Tom that he would receive his table 11 days from now. The estimated date, May 30th, on the BOM overview tells us we can ship the table out of our workshop in 7 days. We only need 2 days to procure components and 5 days to manufacture. We checked the distance from our workshop in San Francisco to Tom's location and verbally told him to expect the package on June 3rd, 4 days from the estimated date. Then, if we go back over here to the sales order, now in this new one, we go inside of other info, down here to delivery dates, and we're going to set this to 7 days from today. Perfect. And would you look at that? Remember, the delivery date is the day you're planning to ship the finished product out of your workshop. We'll get an alert since we set the product to deliver sooner than the 14 days we set on the customer lead time, shown as the expected date down below. But we can actually just ignore it because you Odooers have the power. Now we can save, confirm this, and we're done. Boom. Since we set our driftwood table with the 00 reordering rule, the need will show up on the replenishment page inside of our inventory app. Go to operations up here, replenishment. And there we are, Odooers. Now with this to reorder filter up here, we only see tasks that need to be done. And this one needs to be done right now. So let's reorder by selecting order once. And what did that just do, Odooers? Well, Odoo generates a manufacturing order for us. Would you look at that? Let's hop in there. And looking into this on the MO to build one driftwood table, we could see the scheduled date is 3 days from now since we need 2 days to get the component. And would you look at that? We have a purchase order. Since we set up the 00 reordering rules for the components, Odoo automatically creates POs for the components that we're missing. Now, as you'll see, the order deadline is tomorrow, but we're just going to order it in our case because we need it ASAP. And if we head back over here to our manufacturing order, you'll finally see that in yellow over here that the large wood planks are expected in 3 days. Now the scheduled date is still indicating the latest start time for the production to ensure on-time delivery. Since we already ordered the components, we can begin building once they arrive, so we're on track to finish before the May 30th deadline. Beautiful, Odooers, and there you have it. Odoo makes estimating dates and planning productions easy, while 00 gives you a comprehensive view of scheduled dates to ensure timely manufacturing. Now check out our other videos on planning and the master production schedule coming out soon for more scheduling features. Goodbye for now, Odooers. Go grab a snack, and if no one's told you today, you're doing great. These are hard.